It helps us get in touch with a larger community of STEM-oriented teachers and mentors. And that's a huge benefit for us. And the students get this as well. The students see mentors, and the students see other teachers, and the students see other students who are as energized and engaged about the STEM-related fields.
As a whole, our team is student-driven, student-led. They are the ones who are doing the heavy labor with the robot. And that's the way we want it, because this is their program. There's programmers, we have designers, we have builders, there's people that design our posters, we have people that scout and look and see what other robots are doing. One of the things that we see as leads in our robotics program is we watch our students teach others all the time, and watching them teach helps them to learn even better. It is amazing to watch, especially from progression from freshman to senior, but even within 1 year, to see how they grow throughout that year and watch them to be problem solvers and creative thinkers.
My role here is as the coach, to coach them, to guide them, to facilitate them. I really want the students to be the manager behind the robotics program. I want them to be the leader. I want them to, for it to be their program, their club. I'm really here as a facilitator and an encourager, and to make sure that the program runs smoothly. So start off small, send out flyers, make announcements for male and female groups to come, and have the kits there. And there are lessons, activities online that you can go to. You can go to lego.com, and they also have a lot of activities and curriculum that you can use. And just let the kids play. You will be amazed in what they will make and what they come up with.
Not being shy and keeping myself in.
I learned that with teamwork, you can accomplish way more than just a solo, just being solo.
Like, I've learned to like get out my shell, and I've learned to communicate with people better now, and I think I've grown to be like more of a leader.
I think I've better grown as a leader by being more confident around my team and telling when this thing should be changed or we need to discuss this in a peaceful manner.
You must be dedicated to the team. If you're not, you won't succeed.
I love messing around with these guys. They're my family now, and it's a great experience.
If you want to do it, I would probably do it, because it's a great experience where you can learn and have fun with all your friends, and you can even get like more friends, and even from the competition you can meet everybody that you want.
That the school should do it, because it's fun for the students to do it, and it's very fun, because throughout the experience you learn more things that when you joined the team you didn't know. So you get to learn new experiences, you get to make new friends.
Most definitely. You know, it's an experience that we cannot deny our students. It's an opportunity that they might not have anywhere else. And it's up to us. I mean, to me, it's up to me to provide them this opportunity and this experience that will be a teaching one, a learning one for them.
Our students are going into a world where their jobs are not going to be the ones that we look at. Our students are going into a world where the jobs are going to be different. They're going to change within their lifetime, and they'll have multiple careers over that lifetime. They need critical thinking skills. They need problem-solving skills. They need some of these technical skills, programming, designing. So what I think, if you want to prepare our students for that world that's coming, that we're in right now, they need these skills, and they need these opportunities to collaborate, to work together, to build something together. And so I would say, do anything you can to make it happen, because it's for our kids and they're going to learn. Our program, as young as it is, we have kids that are NASA interns now. We have kids at the engineering program at Texas A&M, first year college, or first generation college Hispanic girl at the engineering program at A&M. And so they're gaining these skills in the program that will lead them down forever. I mean, that's what their life will be because of some of the skills they learned in the robotics program. And for me, it's a joy to be able to allow that to happen and see that happen and help them get to where they want to go.